Today I will show you an uncommon approach how to work with project versions in DaVinci Resolve 19. This technique will allow you to edit projects of any complexity and be able to use project history, timeline history, database history, and all of them combined. So if you'll need to change or reverse something at any point in time, you'll be able to do this. For example, if you're editing a project for a week and you made some mistake on day 3, but on day 7 you figured out that you need to revert it, you'll be able not only to use your existing timeline, but also have a lot of different backups to go back in time. Let's begin and take a look how this can be done. The process has 3 distinctive steps, and now let's take a look on the step 1. This is the backup of your local database. So after we open DaVinci Resolve, we see this project window, and on the left hand side we can see that we have one local database, which by the way are called project libraries since the last version of DaVinci Resolve. But don't worry, it's exactly the same as it was previously. This is local database, which stores all your projects, all your timelines, and it works like a mind map. In my case, I have like 2 main branches or 2 main folders. This is my client projects and my personal projects. So as a first step, you need to have a constant backups of your local databases. We click here on a backup. As you can see, I store everything in my Dropbox folder because I have a personal Dropbox account. It's not a paid one. It has only 20 gigabytes of storage. So it's enough to store maybe 5-6 database versions here. As you can see, the naming convention is very simple. It's the year, the month, and the day. That's it. So if I backed up my local database yesterday, it was the last day of April, and today is the first day of May. So all I have to do is just to change the months from 04 to 05 and to change the day from 30 to 01. That's it. I press save, and that's how I backup my project database on the highest level. Now let's move to step 2. It's backing up our project files. So the idea here is a little bit more complex than with the project libraries or local databases, and it involves creating a few folders and creating a backup structure with archive. As you can see, I have my client projects in dedicated folder and my personal projects in another one. So let's start with any of those. The naming convention starts with 000 archive for personal projects. This means that in this folder, I can drag and drop all of my previous projects which are already completed and I don't have intention to work on them anymore. But just in case I need to get them back, they are always available at my fingertips. So I'll open this project archive 000 and you can see everything goes chronological here. So I have 001, 2, 3 and then 6. You may ask, where is 4 and 5? And the answer is very simple. They are here in my root folder because this means I am working on these projects right now and they are stored in this main centralized place. So if, for example, I finished editing something, I can just right mouse click, select cut and paste them here. Right mouse click, paste. That's it. All you have to do from time to time is just to pay attention what was the number of your last project. In my case, it was 009. So I go back, and for the sake of this tutorial, I create a new folder. I'll give it a name, 010, and the name will be project versioning. I press create, and also I can just copy the name of this folder. I go inside and I press create new project, and I'll give it a name, project versioning 001. So this will be my main project for this folder, and I will be creating versions of this project. So I'm always starting with version 1, obviously, and then we will just increase the number of versions while we work with our timelines. You will see that in the next section of the video, but for now let's press create. And Resolve creates an empty project. So to populate it with some footage, I'll create a new bin and I'll give it a name footage. All of the footage will go here, and I'll create another bin which will be called timelines. Of course, you can create a template for this, but I prefer to start from scratch. I don't use any templates because it just takes maybe a couple of seconds, up to a minute. So I prepared some footage from the GoPro and I'll drag it here in my footage folder. I press change to change project dimensions, because this was filmed in 2997 FPS in 4K. So I'll make my timeline resolution also 4K. I press save and I'll just drag it to my timeline. So after I dragged it to my timeline, as you can see, Resolve created this timeline automatically. So I can just drag the timeline here to the timelines. And now we are moving to versioning of our timelines. So the first timeline, I'll rename it and I'll give it a name, 001 assembly 001. During our editing, we will have a lot of different stages of edit, like assembly, rough cut, fine cut, finer cut, final cut. Then we will work with music, titles, color, and maybe something else like fusion effects or animations or whatever. So as you can see, you can have like up to 10, maybe even 20 stages of editing. And each of these stages can have versioning. So that's exactly why I created this numbering system. The first number shows which stage of the editing we are at, and the last number just shows the version of the stage. Also, for your convenience, you can add letter V in front of the numbers, but I prefer just to keep it simple and tidy. I just use first number of the stage, then the name of the stage, and then the version of the stage. So after I dumped my footage here, I can just create like a few distinctive points. And this will be my like first version of this assembly. Then I'll right mouse click and I'll select duplicate timeline. And we'll rename it to assembly 002. Make sure that you have display stacked timelines button turned on. It will show you the name of the timeline which is currently opened. For example, this is my selects, something I selected in this assembly. And I can also duplicate this timeline once again and give it like a name 003. So it means it's version 3 of our assembly. And don't forget to double click on it and close the previous timeline. Now, when we are ready to move on to our rough cut, all I have to do is to duplicate this timeline again. And I'll just rename it to 002 RC001. So now we are on the second stage of our editing, on the first version of our rough cut. And right now we can do something completely different to our footage. For example, we can like rearrange it, cut it from here, and for example, paste it here. If you forgot to switch your timelines, that's not a problem. You always have a step back. So for example, if I done something here, I can just Command X. I'll remove everything from my assembly 003. I'll put it here. Then I select everything that was in that timeline. I remove this gap and I paste it back here. We just flip the timelines and now everything goes vice versa. So pay attention to it. This happens, but that's okay. And after I've finished like rearranging everything here on rough cut, I just create a duplicate. I give it a second version, open it, make sure that I close the previous one. So here we are doing our rough cut, basically rearranging and putting everything in its place. We can have something like intro, then we can have a middle section of our video, and then we can have an outro. So we created these three sections in our rough cut. I right mouse click on it, duplicate the timeline again, give it a next version number, which is 003, close the previous one, and I give it a name 003, which is for stage 3, and I will call it fine cut or final cut 001. Open it. We can close gaps, whatever. It will be just the final cut of this project. After we are done with the fine cut, I can just create another version and move on to the color. So create 004, color 001, and so on. So this process can be endless. It depends on how many stages of your timelines you need to do and how many versions of each stage you also need to do. I highly recommend to create every new version when you do some major change to your timeline. For example, if you remove something or if you add color to clips to the timeline which doesn't had color previously, or you start to do some audio editing, adding music, everything like this can be named as a stage. And now let's just take a look at the finished project. I'll show you how it looks like in the end when everything is in place. So I'll open one of my client projects, and if I'll go to the timelines, you can see that I started with assembly, then it was a rough cut. Assembly had 8 versions, rough cut had 6 versions. Then I created some zooms and crops, which had 5 versions. Then I had some muted clips removed. I added titles, then I worked with color. Then I did some retitling. And after that was the audio cleanup stage and the render. So I had 9 stages in this project before it was completed and rendered out as the final video. Here are the next steps of how you can benefit from watching this video. Step 1. If you are a video editor and you just starting out your career, you want to learn the video editing software, different editing techniques, tricks and tips, feel free to contact me via the link in the description for this video and book a session with me. We can discuss all your questions and speed up your video editing journey. Second, if you have your own projects and you're looking for a reliable video editor, please check out my Upwork profile and send me a direct message. From there, we can discuss your project and I can become your personal editor. And step 3. If you are already an experienced video editor and you are working on the Upwork but looking to get more clients and land new jobs, you can book a consultation with me and we can discuss your profile, improve your portfolio and take a look at your proposal templates to improve them. I can share my workflow, how I land new jobs on this platform, and I can share it with you. Thank you so much for watching and talk to you soon.